So FHIR is the latest health interoperability standard given out by HL7. And today we are going to be looking at how we can create our first FHIR resource. And let's just go to hl7.com/FHIR. And I'm just going to make this bigger for you to see. So this website is the definitive documentation for the FHIR standard. And now since we are going to be creating a resource, we will first download the JSON schema so that we know that our resource is valid. So go to documentation and go to downloads and just click on the JSON schema under JSON. And I'm just going to put that on my desktop. So once it's downloaded, just extract it here. And I'm going to make a new folder where I'm going to make my first resource. And it's going to be a patient resource. Okay. So now I already have some information about what I want my resource to look like. So this is what I want to convert into a FHIR resource. That's my name. My name is Siddharth Ramesh, by the way, if you already don't know. And so let's get into it. So first I'm going to open this folder and I'm going to open it with VS Code. Install it if you don't have. It's a pretty good text editor. And remember we extracted this FHIR schema last time. Just open that and copy this into our folder. So that's a lot of definitions of what resources should look like. For each resource, they have a different set of constraints and standards. So first we'll set up VS Code to recognize this FHIR schema. So for that, click Control Shift P and open preferences, workspace settings. Just type workspace settings and you should get that. And now this in itself is a JSON. VS Code uses JSON to manage its settings. So we can see now that by pressing control and space, we get a lot of autocomplete options. So what we need is we need json.schema, and you can see that it just auto-completes most of it. Again, control and space and you'll get this. And this is what kind of files do we want to associate with this fire.schema. So let's make that anything that ends with fire.json. And the URL is the file that we have here. So let's use a relative import, fire.schema.json. Okay. And if we create a new patient.fire.json, we should get all the attributes that are associated with a FHIR resource. So let's start with the resource type. That will be patient. And once that is done, all the attributes that are associated with patient will come up in the autocomplete. So first, before getting any further, let's look at the documentation for the patient resource. So let's go down to resources. And here you can see that they are categorized by maturity. N means normative, and it means that it won't change too much in the future. And the higher the number, the better, the more mature something is. And N is finally normative. So let's just go ahead to the patient resource, which is right here. And let's look at all the attributes that they have. There are a lot of attributes, and we don't want to go into all of these. All we want to do today is convert this text thing into a FHIR resource. So let's start with the name. You can see that the name is right here, and it should be, so this is the cardinality. So what this means is it can be minimum zero and maximum as many times as you want. And it should be of the type human name. So let's just go and see what human name means. So human name has its own, definition. And if we just look at the JSON, that'll give you a better idea. So this is how the human names object should be. So let's just go into our resource and start typing out the name. Since we already have autocomplete, it should just give us, let's just do this. Just start with name, and it automatically knows that it should be an array because of the cardinality. It should be multiple elements, right? So we'll just create an object here and then see what all we have. So let's just use, this is my official name, so that's official. And what else do we have? we have given. So let's see what given is all about. So if you go to data type given, and they tell you here that given name not always first includes middle names. This represents this repeating element order. Given name appears in the correct order for presenting the name. So I think this is the this is the attribute that we need to use to represent the first name, although it may not always be the first. So let's use that for Siddharth. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do Siddharth, and Ramesh is my family name. So I'm just gonna go and do family as Ramesh, and that's it. That's how you represent a name. So let's just go down to the gender now. So the gender is male, and my date of birth, it's not DOB, it's date, birth date. See, this autocomplete comes in really handy. So now here I could just paste this in, but as you can see, it's giving me an error. It's not letting me continue. I mean, I could, but the string does not match the pattern this. And what this means is that we did not input this in the correct format. So let's go to patient and see what the birth date should be, the date of birth of the individual, and it should be of type date. Now the type date, it should be one among the following formats. So here I think I could use year, year, month, month, date, date. So let's just do that. 8th September 1997 would be 1997-09-08. That, yeah, and now the error goes away. So that, and then let's do the phone number. So phone number is called telecom, and let's just create an object to see what all we have. So obviously the value would be this, and the use would be home. Or let's make it mobile, and the system is obviously a phone number, right? Because up next we also have the email ID. So for email ID also it comes under telecom, as we can see under you know, our patient resource telecom. Let's just search for telecom. Yeah, a contact detail for the individual, and if we go under telecom, it will give us more information about a telephone number or an email address. So let's just put that in under telecom as well. So now you can see how creating an array is more useful than just putting the object. So system is email, and since we are using JSON, it really doesn't matter. And use, we don't have any use for emails. So value is what we have, tornado@gmail.com. cool, let's go to the next one, address. So address is a little bit trickier than the usual things. So let's just look at how we should represent an address here. So we've got address, and it is of type address. So here there are a lot of attributes here. So we have the use, we have the line, street name, number, city, state, country, and we can, and even the period when this address was in use, if in case the person moved out multiple times. So let's just start with line, because that, we need to create an object first. Line, and first line would be this. Make that a string, and then second line, no, this is the city, so make that the city, Manipal, and that is the state, state, Karnataka, and finally, oh wait, doesn't have pin code. Strange. So okay, the autocomplete is not working as it should. Let's just type pin code. Nope, it's not got pin code. Postal code, it's called postal code. Cool. So you can see how, you know, this autocomplete helps again. So yeah, postal code is the postal code for the area. It's not called pin code according to HL7's fire. So that is our resource, and we can already be assured that this is valid because we had our validator doing all the checks all the time and telling us that things are not valid. So that's how you create a fire resource, and we've successfully created a patient resource. In the next episode, we'll be looking more at how we should be, you know, what we should do with this resource, how we can post it to servers and all that. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, you can put them in the comments down below. I will put up all the links that I used in the description. And thank you for watching.